fast slapback, and then you... What's up? She wants to learn how to make hybrid traps. Okay, let's go. Hi, I'm Ash, and welcome to a very special evening edition. Today I have remixed DaBaby. I made my bitch talk to me when we fuck out back. Big rocks on my wrist, I'm... And I opened it up to just play around and see if I could make anything cool with it. And I actually ended up with something... Okay, let's go. Yeah, so I turned it into this like hybrid trap banger, and I just wanted to walk through how I did it. Let's go. We're just gonna go right into it. Just start out in the drop. What I did, I chopped up the vocal and I got. But then I added. Now let's go in and see how to do that. This chorus gives it that metal sound. You can see with the dry wet, you can make it more or less metallic. And the way it works is that set it all the way down here in the corner so you get that very, very fast slapback. And then you... What's up? She wants to learn how to make hybrid trap. Anyway, the feedback goes all the way up to the very end, which gives it that feedback loop, which makes the metallic sound. Then I just adjust the dry wet. The next thing I add is two things. I add the frequency shifter and I add OTT. So the OTT brings out all of these metallic sounds, and the frequency shifter adds even more harmonics. So like this. And since the original sample has a very nice transient with the get, the frequency shifter and the metallic chorus sound fantastic on these. So that with OTT makes it real squishy, makes it real thick, like this thick boy, so that it really cuts through. I made two separate layers because I wanted a less intense version on these initial hits. So I did it without the frequency shifter. This rhythm here, that's the basis of the entire drop. From there, I moved on to drums. So what I would do is I would listen to this rhythm over and over again. And I would think, where do I put the kicks and snares? And I just mapped them out where it would sound natural. As well for the drum sounds, since it's hybrid trap, and I was going for that 2015 vibe. A really clicky kick, so it just cuts right through the mix. And then the classic, the Jackie snare. Had to do it to him. So that turns into this drum pattern here. How did I decide this rhythm? Like I said, I programmed the drum so it complements the vocal chops. Like this. The next important thing that the drop needs, old school dubstep layer, because the vocal chops need some kind of mid-range bass to help it out. This is super, super simple. In Serum, it's just a sine wave. Can't even hear it. She's so quiet. It's just a little baby sine wave. Where'd you go? And I just add a crap ton of distortion on it. Used auto pan to give it that movement. This is the trick here. If you go into vocoder settings, vocoder presets here in Ableton, this formant plus 5, it gives it a really cool old school dubstep effect. Like this. Now, it doesn't sound like much on its own, but once you layer it with a sub bass, she gets thick. Like this. And our sub, pretty straightforward as well. Sine wave and distortion mixed into taste. Without distortion, and then with distortion. And as always, we match our sub with where the kick hits. And those are the main elements of the drop. You've got the vocal chop, you've got the little dubstep bass, the drums, and the sub bass. From there, you just go ahead, add all your little details. What I like to do is hats, constant hats with sprinkler hats. I found this sample at the very beginning of the original track. It's like a cash bag or something. That makes some really cool fills and layers. And then just some crowd noise to fill out harmonics. And white noise. Came together really, really quick. As for intros, build-ups, the intro just has the drop drums layered over top of it. It works so well with the Jack U snare, I love it. Then for the build-up, I just thought where the song can kind of take a pause, and I just put a bunch of impacts, sub-bass, then the classic, repeat the vocal, and make it faster up until the buildup hits its end, like this. Oh, one more thing, and then this is how you make that vocal pitch up. If you go into envelopes under clip, under transposition modulation, you get this little pink bar here, and you can use it to raise up the pitch so that you can do build-ups, pitch downs, you can do all that fun stuff. Now, I wouldn't consider this finished yet, but I just wanted to give you a quick peek into how to do hybrid trap. That's pretty much it. Find a cool vocal chop, add some cool layers, work the drums around it, and get a nice 808. That's it. Thank you for joining me for this very special evening edition. I'm gonna play the full remix in just a second. Smash the like button, hit subscribe, and I'll release the full download and the project file. Please like and subscribe. Please. I'm desperate. And that's that. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you next time. Peace! Playlist, playlist.